Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about the implementation of agglomerative clustering on Amazon mobile data set. In our previous classes, we clearly discussed about what's Amazon mobile data set and how to do data cleaning, and we used this data set in almost all the implementations. So we are in an assumption that you already know what all these concepts are. So based on that, we are continuing this class. So please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete machine learning language. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, the implementation of agglomerative clustering, these are the packages which we use here for data cleaning and data preprocessing. We are taking our Amazon mobile data set from this file .csv file, and we are doing data preprocessing and data cleaning and data preprocessing. This is the code for data cleaning and data preprocessing. So after doing the data cleaning and data preprocessing, so the new file which obtained from data cleaning and data preprocessing is cleaned data set. From the cleaned data set, we are taking only 5000 data records for easy to execution, because it will take a lot of time for execution. We are considering only 5000 records. In our Amazon mobile data set, we are having 70,000 data records. Based on your CPU capability, you can take any number of records. Okay, now we are converting into training and testing data set. After that, we are converting into bag of words. So all this coding document and the data set document is provided in the description below. So if you click on the link, you can get the download of this coding document and data document. So coming to this, after that we will convert into bag of words. After converting into bag of words is a sparse matrix. After converting into bag of words, we will get a sparse matrix. But here in agglomerative clustering, it will take a dense matrix. That's why the testing data set which we considered from bag of words, trained underscore cleaned text dot to, we are converting into dense matrix. We use this function to array of for converting our data into dense matrix. We are placing it in a variable called L. So in our previous classes, when we discussed about k-means clustering, there we discussed about SIL-HOT method. So why we use SIL-HOT method? For identifying the best number of clusters, for identifying the k value. For k is equal to 2, for k is equal to 5, k is equal to 8, which one is getting the highest SIL-HOT score, that k will be identified. The same way here we will use SIL-HOT method for identifying the best number of clusters. So we are using the same code which we applied in the k-means clustering, identifying the SIL-HOT score. The only difference which we consider here is agglomerative clustering. In place of k-means, we are using agglomerative clustering. This is in the package from sklearn.cluster, import agglomerative cluster. Other than that, everything is same. N underscore clusters is equal to N underscore clusters, which is taken from this value. So we are taking different values 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Out of that, which one is getting the highest SIL-HOT score, that value is considered as the best number of divisions. So best number of clusters. Okay, now we'll take a look at the agglomerative clustering pack. Clustering. So what this is, N underscore clusters means number of clusters. By default, it is 2. So we can change to any value 10, 11, 12. By default, it will be 2. And the next thing which we have to consider here is in the agglomerative clustering, linkage. In our last class, we discussed that linkage, different linkages, and how they affect on our data set. That we clearly discussed. There we discussed 4 methods. What are those? Single linkage. Single linkage means minimum point. Complete linkage means maximum distance, and the average linkage and WODS method. So by default in agglomerative clustering, it is taking default is equal to WODS method. So we are using the same as a WODS method. You can change according to your situation and identify different linkages and check your output. So these are the important things which we have to learn from agglomerative clustering. Now check the output. So for k is equal to n number of clusters is equal to 2, the average SIL-HOT score is 0.69. This is the highest value which we got for n underscore clusters is equal to 2. So 2 is the best number for dividing our entire data set into 2 clusters. So this is all about agglomerative clustering. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. The link to download this coding and data document is provided in the description below. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.